howdy.
I need 9 chairs here. You need to go away.
Chair.
And now once again tempers flare as a new art
As the Capulets and Montagues spilled into the Verona streets. Benvolio, a friend of Romeo, tried to settle the fight.
A young man, Benvolio, plunged into the fray.
Park fools!
He shouted in a worried way.
Put up your swords! You not know what you do!
For he was a gentleman, yet a Montague too. But Tybalt, the Capulet, who welcomed his wrath, stormed into the group like a thunderclap.
Turn thee, Benvolio, look upon thy death. I will hate the word Montague until my last breath.
Within seconds, the marketplace was aroar, as Verona's citizens joined by the shore. Then trumpets hailed the mighty prince, making both families cower and wince. Prince Aeschylus declared,
This violence must keep Romeo's subjects and enemies to peace.
His face was severe as he looked around.
Throw your distempered weapons to the ground. If ever again you go astray, be it known now, with your lives you will pay. You, Capulet, shall come with me, and Montague this afternoon will go in. I demand from you both the chain depart. Once more on the pain of death, depart.
In scene two, Benvolio, Romeo's friend, tries to find out why he is sad. Shelby will narrate this scene.
But one young lad had stayed away and did not brandish a sword that day. Romeo Montague was his name, a nobleman of great wealth and fame. He sat alone in his chamber room and looked about in a state of gloom. His mood was hard for his parents to endure. Benvolio, his friends, told them he'd find a cure.
See where he comes, so please step aside. I'll know his agreements or much to deny. Good morrow, cousin. What trouble overpowers? What sadness lengthens Romeo's hours?
It didn't take long to ascertain the cause of Romeo's heartache and pain. He was devoted to a lady divine, a beautiful woman called Rosaline.
She has sworn to love and end that vow. Do I look dead, outlive to tell it now?
Benvolio cautioned.
Don't be so blind. Banish this female from your mind. Take my advice and do not despair. Examine other beauties and compare.
Romeo moaned.
I remember her still. I love Rosaline. I always will.
Scene 3 is not enacted. In it, the Capulets plan a grand party to launch their only daughter, Juliet, into Verona society. Meanwhile, a young count by the name of Paris asks for Juliet's hand in marriage. Her father, not wanting to force Juliet to an unwelcome match, agrees to allow Paris to woo Juliet and win her heart, inviting him to the party that night. Meanwhile, a servant is dispatched to town to invite the guests. He mistakenly tells Romeo and his friends about the party and shows them the guest list. Romeo sees his beloved Rosaline's name on the list and decides to crash the party. We continue with scene 4. Juliet is told about Count Paris. Caleb will narrate.
At the Capulets, there was quite a fuss. Juliet's mother had something to discuss.
Tell me, daughter, would you like to marry?
Juliet was shocked. Her voice grew weary.
It is an honor I do not owe.
But her mother continued to talk of love.
The valiant Paris seeks you for his wife. His charms and wealth will enhance your life. I advise you to give him a chance at least. Observe his parents tonight at the feast.
The nurse joined in with more words of praise.
Scene 5 is not enacted. In scene 5, while walking to the party and in the mood for fun, Romeo is struck with a strange premonition of doom. He wonders if the night's events will bring about tragedy. But then he casts his fate to the stars and decides to go through with his plans to woo the fair Rosaline in disguise. Scene 6, picks up at the Capulet party, and Laurenz will narrate this.
Capulets greeted guests at the great hall.
Welcome, my friends, one and all. Join the party,
he said with a grin.
Come, musicians, let the mirth begin.
In a matter of moments, the room was aglow. The ladies and gentlemen danced to and fro. But Romeo stood by himself with a sigh. In some instant, his eyes opened wide. He gazed on a vision he'd never forget. Across the room was the fair Juliet. Now Rosaline's body has lost its glow.
What lady is that?
Asked Romeo.
Oh, she'll teach the torches to burn bright. I never saw such beauty till this night.
His words were heard by a Capulet nearby. Tybalt was enraged.
This man I defy, and by the honor and stock of my kin, I strike him dead and hold it not sin.
But across the room where Capulet strode, he observed Tybalt's anger ready to explode.
Calm yourself,
Capulet said in a low tone.
You will not spoil this party. Leave him alone,
Tybalt cried.
This is a Montague, our foe. 'Tis he, that villain Romeo.
Capulet hissed.
Am I the master here? Are you? Stop this insolent behavior. It will not do. I will withdraw.
Tybalt sneered with disdain.
But this intrusion shall lead to pain.
Now Romeo heard none of this heated debate, for his thoughts what the lady would not abate. His eyes locked with Juliet's across the room. His identity was hidden by a masked costume. She was even more beautiful as he drew near, and the warmth of her smile was so sincere. Her eyes grew bright. She felt total bliss. Romeo took her hand and begged a kiss. The lovers embraced. Their hearts were set beating. But the rapture they felt, alas, was fleeting. Juliet's nurse appeared from out of the blue. Reluctantly, Juliet had to obey, and with a backward glance, she turned away.
What is her mother?
Romeo inquired. The nurse replied.
My mother's divine. The lady of the house and the woman is wise and virtuous, and I'm all here.
Then the nurse turned and she rushed away. Romeo was stunned and filled with dismay.
Oh dear, Count, my wife is a foe's dead. The woman that I love is a Capulet.
Soon Benvolio beckoned, it was time to leave.
There's nothing here more to achieve.
Now Juliet too was in a trance.
Was that Panther share?
Who is that man? You share my man? Don't let him go. Ask him his name. I need to know. If he be there.
Juliet said.
My grave could be my wedding day.
When she heard it, she was a Montague, she couldn't believe that it was true.
My only love spoke from my only hate, too early seen, unknown, and not too late. Prodigious birth of love it is too late, but I must love, it live, and obey.
The nurse replied.
In scene 7, smitten with a new love, Romeo is in no mood to be teased by his friends. While they search for him in the streets of Verona, Romeo jumps a garden wall and finds himself below a balcony of the Capulet house. Scene 8 is the famous balcony scene, and Cheyenne will narrate that.
Shrouded in darkness, Romeo looked around.
My friend's dressed at scars.
He sadly frowned.
Though she's not alone, you have felt it. Your felt it aches but soft, but like the yard the window breaks.
Romeo quivered, his heart took a leap. His beloved Juliet was not asleep. She stepped onto the balcony into the night. Romeo was entranced by the shining light.
It's the east, and Juliet is the sun. Her beauty cannot be outdone.
As Romeo watched, from his hiding place. To the stars above, Juliet stated her case.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo.
Her eyes were aglow.
Wherefore art thou, Romeo? 'Tis with thy name that is my enemy. Without the remorse of you, we would be free. If that cannot be, my name I'll forget, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Romeo, draw thy name.
Romeo, draw thy name. That is no part of me.
Romeo proclaimed,
"My name on stone."
Juliet was amazed. She thought she was alone.
Who is that made out in the shadow of night, attending my secrets out of sight?
When she saw it was Romeo, she felt dismay.
Oh, you must leave. If any of my kinsmen see you here, they will murder me. That is clear.
Romeo answered,
"I'm not afraid. My love for you will never fade. Juliet, you must give me a sign to show you for thy love.
So under the shimmering stars above, Juliet gave her pledge of love.
Saucy merchant.
What saucy merchant is this?
She retorted in shock.
A gentleman,
Romeo said.
He wants to hear himself talk. Renounce Juliet, bid her come soon to the fire cell this afternoon. My servant will bring a rope ladder too, so we can perform our rendezvous. But now, quickly, there's too long we have to tarry. To the fire cell, me and you will be there.
Scene 11 is not enacted. In scene 11, Juliet's nurse rushes back to tell Juliet with the news that Romeo has arranged for them to be married at Friar Laurenz's cell that very day. Romeo waits eagerly with his good friend the friar, who is about to make his dreams of love come true. Scene 12, Romeo and Juliet get married. Sydney will narrate this scene.
At the monk's cell, Romeo was elated. He spoke with Laurenz and impatiently waited. The friar prayed to the heavens above.
Smile on his lips and bless his love. We'll soon after hours with sorrow. Try this not.
For the friar with nine doubts was fried, but when Juliet arrived and her love he beheld, Laurenz's worries were quickly dispelled.
Tybalt had started. Romeo rather than sentence him to death. But he cautioned that if Romeo had not left Verona by morning, he would be executed. In scene 15, Juliet learns of the fight and Tybalt's death. Cheyenne will narrate.
Now Juliet knew nothing of the terrible fight. She paced in her room, awaiting the night. Each hour to her seemed terribly long. Then a nurse arrived, but something was wrong. She was wringing her fingers and stared straight ahead.
I like the day. He's gone. He's killed. He's dead.
We're not in town, lady. How could we have known? Whatever about it, Romeo.
Have Romeo slain himself.
Juliet grew tense.
Don't keep me, oh good nurse, don't keep me in suspense. Oh, Tybalt, Tybalt.
The nurse hung her head.
That ever I should live to see you again.
Juliet cried.
You mean both are gone? Who is left living so I can carry on?
Romeo killed Tybalt.
The nurse sounded wild.
Tybalt is gone and Romeo exiled.
Juliet's eyes grew wide. She felt her heart thud.
Romeo sped away.
filled with pride.
So may be a joyful ride.
Never!
Juliet shouted.
I will not marry yet.
Then into the room strode Lord Capulet.
Good wife, have you told our daughter the plan?
I have, my lord. She refuses me.
Capulet glared at his daughter.
You will obey. My word to Paris, I won't betray. To St. Peter's Church, I'll find you the course, or I'll drive you there by force.
Juliet wailed.
Oh, good father, I beseech you on my knees. Hear me with patience, if you please.
Not. Speak not,
he replied.
For I do not jest. Till you marry the count, I will not rest, or hang, beg, starve, die in the streets.
And with that, her father made a hasty retreat.
Oh, good mother, don't keep me in suspense.
Yes, ma'am.
Cast me not away.
This marriage
you must try to delay.
Lady Capulet scoffed.
Talk not to me. Do as thou wilt, for I have done with thee.
Juliet was spared.
I must think of a boy.
I must think of a boy. Good nurse, has thou had a word of joy?
The nurse encouraged.
The count's a fine
catch. The count's a fine catch. Another of the cabin will set the match.
And from your soul too.
Speakest thou?
Wait, speakest thou from my heart?
And from my soul too.
The nurse.
The nurse replied, even her servant had proven untrue. Juliet thought of the bride.
He'll know what to do.
Scene 20 takes place in Friar Laurenz's cell as Juliet and Friar Laurenz formulate a desperate plan. Shelby narrates.
But Friar Laurenz already had a guest. Count Paris was there with his marriage request. He longed to begin wedded life. Then he saw Juliet.
My fleeting wife, in just a few days you'll be married to me.
Juliet replied. Count Paris noticed nothing amiss.
Until then, adieu. Keep this holy kiss.
Then from the monastery, Paris sped. Juliet's heart was filled with dread.
Oh, good friar,
she sobbed.
Come weep with me. Past hope, past care, past hope you seek.
Wait, my child, there's a glimmer of hope. I have a plan, but it's desperate in scope. Before you decide or give your consent, listen out the strife to vent. Go home, be merry, and your parents confide. Tell them you will be Count Paris's bride. Then tomorrow night, drink from this vial, a potion most rare.
He outlined the plan as she listened in fear, but Juliet knew her only hope was set here. Her blood would soon chill, and she would feel weak. Her eyelids would droop, and she would not speak. The rose in her lips and cheeks would fade. No warmth, no breath, no pulse be displayed. This likeness of death from the potion's powers would continue to work for many hours.
When your parents find you in bed, they will believe that you are dead. The Capulet's tomb you will be laid. That they'll send word to Romeo about the charade. Then out of this death-like slumber sleep, you will awaken as if from a sweet sleep. Your Romeo and I will be there. And we will take you to Mantua in your care.
Juliet's face grew flush.
I will do the deed. Love will bring you the strength to succeed.
Scene 21. Juliet decides to take the potion. Sydney narrates.
Juliet rushed home with hopeful belief.
Wait.
Juliet rushed home with hopeful belief. Her father greeted the change with relief.
I decided
bedroom, Juliet quickly withdrew to advance the friar's plan. Step two. She advised in manner polite. But now her courage began to wane. Horror and panic filled her brain. Juliet's flesh began to crawl.
What if the mixture doesn't work? What if the friar is a fake? Oh, could this all be an awful mistake? Romeo, Romeo, you hold the key.
She lifted the vial. The nurse turned tail.
Help, help, my lady is dead.
Juliet's mother was standing nearby. She rushed into the room when she heard the outcry.
Oh me, my child, my only life.
Then Capulet strode in.
What's the matter, wife?
Alas, she lamented.
You're gonna be old.
When he touched Juliet's body, she was cold. Then the friar sent by Paris appeared below.
The bride ready to go?
Lord Capulet spoke low. His voice shook with concern.
Ready to go, but never to return. Death has taken his wife. Death take my son-in-law. Death take my life.
But the friar felt no grief in his heart. Soon Romeo and Juliet would have a fresh start. By his friend, Friar John, the message had been sent, explaining to Romeo each strange event. Friar Laurenz beseeched.
Dry up your tears, floss away all your earthly fears, and as the custom is,
Our best array.
Bear Juliet to church today. I will lie with Romeo and Juliet.
That's brave.
what you say.
Scene 24 is not enacted. In scene 24, Friar Laurenz hears to his horror that because his messenger was stopped from entering Mantua, Romeo has not been told the scheme to fake Juliet's death. And he rushes to the Capulet tomb to be there when Juliet awakens.
Then fell to the ground by Romeo's side.
26, the families reconcile. Shelby, marriage.
Both families arrived at this sad scene, but it was too late to intervene. Before the prince, they knelt in grief. Their children's lives had been much too brief. Prince Aeschylus stood solemn in the tomb. His voice of reason shattered the gloom.
See what your pain.
See what a scourge laid.
See what scourge has
laid upon your
hate. Laid upon your hate.
Your beloved ones are
dead. Your beloved ones are dead on the back of the stage.
And I for winking.
And I for winking.
And your discords too.
And your discords too.
Have lost a brace.
Have lost an embrace and King's been true.
Finally,
our family seldom were wrong, and seldom appeared after much too long. Lord Capulet and I, Lord Montague, clasped hands in peace, there was much overdue. Statues of the lovers were raised out of gold, so all could remember and behold. For no, there was no other story more woe than that of Juliet and her Romeo.
Happy Memorial Day!
There's
food. We can go shoot pool a little bit. We're up in the Hyatt. We're just going to take a picture of this bird. It's right up on top of this. It took off?
No, it's still there.
Okay.
Here's your first one. Despite its alpine image, what brand of hot cocoa mix was actually cooked up by a Sicilian American in the 1950s?
Swiss Miss.
Stop shaking the bed. Good job. He's about ready to take off again.
There's another one.
Well, I can only focus on one at a time. If I try to focus on another one.
Curious George.
Come on, move, you stupid.
More lucrative than making burgers, what is the real estate term for buying?
He just don't want to move. He must be tired. Let me know if he moves and I'll take a picture. Okay, we're up on the 14th floor of the Hyatt. It is June the 12th. Is that right?
Flipping burgers, flipping houses. That's your first strike, guys. Be careful. Two more goes, and I've got to throw it out. Okay, 17 blocks to go. Here's your final $50 question. Candy against
he's on a stick.
And Philistine giants.
And it's blowing all over the place. He's balancing on it.
Slingshot.
Come on, bird. Take off.
already has her $250. That's it for the $50 questions.
Yeah, because apparently it's going to...
I don't know if you can do it.
Here's your first one.
Can you stop shaking me? Yeah.
A 1969 clash with police.
This is what you call total, utterly bored to death.
That's what you call boredom. That's what you call Laurenz.
This is from the other side of the hotel. Looking out. Thought maybe we could see Chicago, but can't. And it's a nice looking building over there. It's probably Brooklyn Zoo. That looks like the monkey house at the Brazil Zoo. Frank and Mimi. Just kind of hanging out.
That earthquake.
We're in Chicago at Girlie's cousin's house. Hey, how are you? All right, look how big you got.
Oh, that's him.
In high school?
I'm a senior.
That's great.
That's it.
Well, just in case he was there, we didn't want to walk by.
Go upstairs. I'll go.
Oh my gosh, last time I seen you, you were like this. You and Laurenz, I got a picture of you two inside of a little tiny car together, trying to play with that little plastic car.
I like your hair. What day are you in now?
He's in Britain today, so... He called me, he's on his way home now. You want anything?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
Where's
my van? I'll give you a lot.
Mimi. Everybody look and say cheese. On three.
Cheese.
How about food?
Excuse me.
It's okay.
Food.
I'll take it a video anyways. I was just messing.
Cold.
Water?
Just ice water.
Ice water. Give me.
Ice water, please.
Ice water.
Really?
Cold.
Mimi, that tire, that put my
zero.
Zero. Okay.
That put my teeth. That put my teeth.
I found it. Yeah.
Does anybody
want to know where the restroom
facilities
are?
On the side.
Side.
They're nice. No.
More.
Go to
the door.
There you go.
Hindi pa rin sasalita ako, Kuya Desu. Ayan, may mga kaibigan na sa bahay, may ano sila.
You're very welcome.
I was gonna help.
Look at the chocolate.
Can I have some?
Well, I'll give you one.
No.
Thank you.
Let's dig on drums, everybody.
It's a Friday, right?
Right.
Yeah, he's playing tonight. He's off.
Well,
Hi, Mimi.
What?
Hi, Mimi.
Right?
The more the Mimi.
There's Frank. Trying to hide. Okay. Then we're going to the planetarium. A little chilly. It's June the what, the 13th? Today's 13th? Today it's the 13th, I think. I'm not sure. But it's June. And the lakefront in Chicago. So mist coming out the sky. It's probably about, must be about 70 degrees. Laurenz, where you at, Laurenz? Mm. Where you at?
Yeah.
What's the name of this place? Is this how you want to be preserved for the rest of your life? Mm. Portraying somebody with a mental condition? Mm-mm. Well, you kind of sound that way.
No.
You sound exactly like one. Mm. We're going on a tour. What is the name of this, Laurenz? Adler. Spear.
Turn to a roller coaster.
That's the secret part.
Yeah, awesome.
That's the super secret part.
Oh god. It's hard to.
That's why I just lay back here and then just stay here the whole time.
I don't know if that's coming out on camera, but it's a bunch of holes in this big giant dome.
You can sit down during your audio.
And this dome was originally designed back in 1913 for people to learn about the stars.
Okay, so what we're doing here is I have to play two pieces of audio that's going to give you the history and all the story about the sphere itself, and then I give a brief constellation show about what you're going to be able to see if it ever clears up tonight. So here goes the first part.
Hello, and welcome to the Adler Planetarium. For your safety and the safety of those around you, please keep your hands inside the carriage and remain seated at all times. What you're entering is called the Atwood Sphere, Chicago's first planetarium. Originally, it belonged to the Chicago Academy of Sciences and opened in 1913. The Atwood Sphere is a 15-foot wide form of pattern. In 1928, the International Astronomical Union recognized 88 official constellations covering the entire sky. There are 58 constellations represented in the Atwood Sphere. 30 of these have been painted to allow you to see the shape of the constellation. This is the Big Dipper.
Straight ahead.
You can use the Big Dipper to help you find the North Star or Polaris. Use the pointer stars at the end of the bowl of the Dipper. They point directly to the North Star. The North Star is not the brightest star in the sky. Actually, there are 41 other stars in the sky that are brighter. The North Star is important, however, because the Earth's North Pole points directly at it, and it's visible all night long in the Northern Hemisphere. You can always use it to find the direction north.
Coming out of the Adler Dome Planetarium thing. Showed us the star constellations.
You've all been great.
Alright, thank you.
No problem.
And that's what it looks like from the outside.
They tied 1-1. They tied 1-1.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. That was kind of cool. This is Laurenz, next to a meteorite. Show you what the meteorite looks like. Right there.
Yeah,
ending light. It's bent. This is about bending light. Watch. It's huge. Go stand over there, Laurenz. Try to get a perspective. Look at that. Okay. To get the picture they're looking for. Somebody's got flags all over their car. Of course, the lake. That's weird looking. Front. Okay, let's walk this way. Ooh, that's hot. I guess we're not allowed to go in there. Okay, come on. Hey, where you at?
Where's the headquarters?
Okay, we just got finished. We did that one little ride down there on the bottom floor, and we're up on the top floor right now. And then we're going to the second floor real quick. We'll be down there.
Okay.
All right, love you. Bye.
Hurry up.
Yeah, we're hurrying. Bye. Laurenz, look at that big boat. Laurenz! Shoot, Laurenz, shoot.
Oh.
Ooh, what a hit. Any idea?
Yeah.
Mars rover.
I was with Dad!
Yeah, I know, but what happened to you? Your dad came and you're not there.
I am fine.
God.
She just needs to
go. Shh, go ahead.
Shut up.
Somebody's getting married over there.
Hey?
What?
Burnt up.
Dad,
what?
Shut up. You want to walk around? What?
You think this is where Godzilla was supposed to be at?
What are you talking about?
The new Godzilla movie.
I don't know, is it?